is day two of the 2020 muzzleloader season. I've got a doe tag in my pocket. My son's got a buck tag and a doe tag. So I can't wait to see what happens. I think we're in pretty good shape, so better shut up and get off here. I'll see you soon. Well, I got busted. The wind's been real screwy this morning. It's been variable. It'll blow that way for a while, then it'll blow that way, and then that way, and that way. Had three does come in behind me. At least three. That's all I could see for sure. And that lead doe, the lead doe of the bunch, man, she just locked it up. And I didn't have a good shot on her anyway, so I didn't take it, but she was gone. She locked it up. She smelled me, kind of stood there for a second. The other two come up behind her, and she turned and bolted. Of course, they went with her, but I'm hoping they went toward my son, because he texted me just a few minutes later and said he had some coming, so I'm waiting for a shot on that. Kind of hoping so. It's nice and cool today. It'd be a good day to tag one. But they come in right on cue at 9 o'clock, 8:57 to be exact. So hopefully that's not the last one I see. So, getting pretty chilly. I don't know how much more I can stand sitting on this metal tree stand. I forgot my pad this morning. So I'm sitting on bare metal, and it, according to my phone, it's 23 degrees. But anyway, we'll see what happens. Stay tuned.
I was hearing something down the hill. I'm gonna say it's gone now. But there ain't no doubt in my mind that my dad just shot up there, because he about to give me a heart attack. Whew. Okay. That just about gave me as much of an adrenaline rush as shooting a deer, so I'll get off here, put the GoPro back in my pocket, and call him.
I should have nailed her. She didn't really attached to the shot. So that's always a little nerve-wracking, but I mean, just after I shot, she disappeared over the hill, so she should be done, though. Had a pretty decent rest, had the crosshairs right on her. And I'm shaking, one, because I shot a deer, and two, because it's about 23 degrees and I'm cold. But not making excuses. I always shake after I shoot a deer. So I'll get myself together here in a minute and we're gonna go look for blood. So stay tuned. Guys, we're still on the blood trail. This deer's run 125 yards. I can't believe it. My son come out of his stand to join me in the tracking job. This is Hunter, by the way. But we've got all kinds of blood, so we're gonna stay on the blood trail. And we're getting close to the property line though, so I'm getting kind of nervous. We're gonna make sure she didn't cross that property line. And if she did, then we're going to have to call the property owner and get permission to go keep tracking her. But, I mean, she's still bleeding real good, and I can't believe she's made it this far. But I am using a new bullet this year, so, again, a little nervous about that. You know, they're supposed to be the best of the best. You know how that goes. So we're going to get back to the blood trail. This deer is just spraying blood over here. Leave the tank this far. Should have got a double lung on her, she's only 40 yards. She is turning away from the property line though, so that's a good sign. Oh, goodness, look at this. Just look at this. And you can just follow it on up through there. The bad thing is, property line is right there, and I ain't seen her yet.
Well, there is blood everywhere. Look at this. It's all down here. Your blood energy, I can see it way down here. I know you all probably can't on the GoPro, but I mean, it's just, it's like following a big old trail, just basically just like walking a trail. It runs all the way through here.
Guys, I see a white belly. I think that's her. And she's on our side of the fence. Just barely, because there's the fence.
50 yards from it.
She turned a little bit. Oh, thank God. Yes.
Well, she apparently turned at like the last second, because Dad is following the blood trail. And she's laying right up there. So she probably went right next to the property line. Cause I mean, I'm standing easily 30 yards away from the property line. So let's go check out this deer.
Done for sure. Thank you, Jesus. She gone. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, she just quit bleeding, it looks like.
Oh, I can't believe she went that far. And it looks like I actually hit her just a little bit back.
Uh-huh. No, didn't put in a little
look
bit.
At the head on that thing. She looks like she ought to be a buck. Oh, well, guys, we got it done this morning with a big, big healthy doe. She disappeared over the hill just after the shot. And my goodness, she ran about 150, 175 yards. I don't know how she had anything left in her to get as far as she did, but regardless, proof's in the pudding. We got her done. Thank the Lord for this. Should put some good meat in the freezer. We're gonna get her field dressed and tagged, and we're gonna get to work. Well, I hope you enjoyed that video. That was a pretty exciting deer hunt. You know, some of you may just say, well, that was just a doe, but that was a pretty exciting doe hunt. Couldn't believe she made it as far as she did. But we had a happy ending. We found her, got her in the freezer, and been enjoying that meat ever since, which is why we do what we do. So thanks for watching the Hawkins Outdoor Experience, and we'll see you soon in the Mushroom Woods or the Turkey Woods. God bless.